Have you ever wondered why some cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin have a strict max supply, while others like Ethereum seem to say, "The sky's the limit"? Don't worry, I'm here to explain it all without the boring lecture, and with a little humor. Let's start with the max supply gang. These are the cryptos that play hard to get. Take Bitcoin for example. It has a cap of 21 million coins. That's it, no more, no less. It's like the limited edition sneaker of the crypto world. Everyone wants it because it's rare, and as we know, humans love things that are hard to get, like my dog when he doesn't want to come inside. Now on the other side, we have cryptos with no max supply. These are the ones that keep going and going, like that one friend who never stops talking about their workout routine. Ethereum, for instance, doesn't have a hard cap. Instead, it relies on something called controlled inflation. Think of it as baking new cookies, enough to keep the jar full, but not so many that the whole kitchen overflows. But why? Why do some cryptos love to limit themselves, while others are out here making it rain? It all comes down to design philosophy. Cryptos with max supply like Bitcoin are designed to mimic gold, a finite, scarce resource. This scarcity makes them appealing as a store of value. Think of it as the digital gold everyone keeps talking about. Meanwhile, cryptos with no max supply, like Ethereum, are more like tools. They're built to power ecosystems, smart contracts, decentralized apps, and so on. They need enough coins to keep everything running smoothly, but not so many that the value drops faster than my patience in a traffic jam. A crypto supply is like the recipe for your favorite dish. Too little or too much of one ingredient, and the whole thing falls apart. Join us and reach your next crypto level.